Welcome to our course about structured data. We're going to dive into structured data in this lesson, and after this lesson you'll be able to explain the concept of holistic SEO, which is what we use to encompass everything we do, and you'll be able to grasp the basic beginnings of what structured data is. So let me talk about holistic SEO. Holistic SEO is the way that we do SEO at Yoast. To understand that, you have to first understand Google's mission. Google's mission is to organize the world's information and make it universally accessible and useful. Now, we as SEOs, we aim to improve a website's organic position, so a position in the free, or what we call organic, results. And we try to do that in a way that we do not use any scorched earth tactics. We do not spam. We do not buy links. We do not do stuff that Google does not condone. We prefer sustainable SEO. And to do that, you have to focus on all the aspects of website optimization, and you have to actually be the best result. Holistic SEO to us is many things combined into one. It's technical excellence, it's quality content, it's good UX and good UI, it's flawless security, it's awesome PR and social. It's all these things combined. But it, as I said, one of the things in there is technical excellence. So technical SEO is an integral part of good SEO. Now, we have a course on technical SEO in which we explain things like canonical and robots.txt. We talk about meta tags and all these things. But in that course, we do not talk about structured data. That's what this course is for. We talk about structured data, and specifically structured data as it relates to schema.org and the things that Google can work with and does stuff with in their search results. So, what will you learn? You will explain what structured data is and why it is important for SEO. You will understand the use of structured data throughout the web, and you will be able to implement your own structured data on your WordPress site. So we have three modules in this course. Module one is, what is structured data? Module two is implementing structured data, and module three is the practical use of structured data. That's a whole lot of structured data, but what is structured data? Structured data is basically metadata. It's how we tell Google what we're talking about. We make structured data using a schema, a taxonomy, if you wish. Like there is a taxonomy in biology of animals and species, schema.org is a taxonomy of everything. So in this course, we'll go over all of that, and we'll tell you which parts of this whole schema.org setup are useful to you now. Now, this is an evolving thing. Schema.org is rapidly evolving. So we'll cover what Google does as we record this video, but we'll also give you the tools to see where Google and other search engines are improving this, to see how you could use it in the future. Now, that's a whole lot of things to take in, so do a little bit more reading and do your exercises.
So, after each lesson, I will come in and ask the questions and the things that I didn't understand in your story.
Okay.
So, I'm a bit confused in your use of both structured data and schema.org. So, what's the difference?
So, schema.org is one method of structured data. It's the only one we'll talk about in this course.
But there are other methods.
Yeah, absolutely. So way back in the past, we used to have microformats, which was another way of marking things up as cards or as whatever. There are multiple ways of doing structured data. There are multiple taxonomies for things. And structured data is usually the combination of a taxonomy like schema.org and a type of markup. JSON-LD is the one we'll cover in this course, but we'll talk about that later on.
That's fine. So schema.org is the one method of structured data we're talking about in this course. Yeah. Then I have another question. I think thinking about structured data, it's a SEO tactic in which you actually communicate with Google.
Yes.
I think that makes it different from other tactics like writing for the search engines.
It's weird actually, because we're doing stuff specifically for the search engines, which is also something we've always told people not to do. At the same time, structured data can be read by everyone. So structured data is useful for a lot more things than just Google. So Pinterest reads your structured data, Facebook reads your structured data, Apple reads it.
And Google is okay with it.
Yeah, because it's open. It's an open way of improving the web and improving the way that search engines and machines can read web pages just as well as people can.
So it's a very active SEO strategy, right?
It's a very, very active SEO strategy. It's a lot of work.
So let's go to it.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
You've got a lot of reading and exercises to do, so well, go do that, and then we'll see you in the next lesson.